Oh, there's a wasp. Hey. So, today I just wanted to talk about ambition and how hard it can be when you're ambitious, focused and driven to achieve the dreams that you once had, you know, growing up, and how circumstances of your life and situations within your life can sometimes come in between that and affect your focus and affect basically the belief you once had to achieve them ambitions. But yeah, I'll talk about it today purely because it's just something I've been thinking about, and no matter what comes in between, I've always somehow found a way of, even if it takes longer, of getting there to where I'm going. But although on numerous occasions I've got lost with my vision and what I want and what I want to achieve, but then every time I get lost, something happens in order to find my path again and a new way of achieving my vision. So I try to be ambitious, but at the same time I try to not have my hopes and expectations too high. I just kind of try and go with the flow. Take things as they come, and let it take its course, basically. That's not switching off from being... Oh, there's a wasp. Oh, I hate wasps. Right. Oh, it's one thing I hate about summer, when the wasps come back. I'm really flinching now. At the same time, as that's a saying, isn't it? Ambition can kill. Basically, it can either break you or make you. So you have to be able to stay on a level, and definitely before you try and achieve anything in life, you have to know yourself. So you have to know your weaknesses, you have to know your strengths, and you have to know your mind and how it works, because we don't all work in the same way. How someone might have achieved success isn't necessarily how you're going to be able to achieve it. So right now I don't really know what my success is going to be. I already feel successful because I'm doing what I always wanted to do. I'm a personal trainer, I'm running my own business. So although that's a battle every day, it's never easy. Once you get to that point, it's not it. You're still working, you still want to achieve more. There's always, as I say, when you're ambitious, you're kind of never satisfied. You always want more, and it's not a case of greed, it's a case of ambition, being ambitious, you know. You just want to be better, and you want to do better, and you want to give more, and you want to... So yeah, it's just a case of don't put your eggs in one basket. Be open-minded to listening and trying different methods and different ways of getting to where you want to get, because it might be the path you had set isn't necessarily how you're going to get there, isn't necessarily going to have no diversions, because life is life, right? It has things arise, things get in the way. Change is inevitable. That's one saying I absolutely love, because change, no matter how much we all hate it, we all want it at the same time, you know. We want to change, we want to have different things, we want life to be exciting. So change, although it's hard, and to adapt and understand things are going to be different, it's inevitable. Everything changes, it's daily, things are changing. What you might have been blessed with once is now a lesson, you know? It's, you've learned, you've experienced, and going forwards, it's just a matter of using it in your life. It's a matter of using that lesson and using that experience to progress you and get you further in your next chapter, you know? So, although something was a blessing, if it's no longer going to be in your life, you have to accept it was a lesson, or it was something that's just was only meant to be in your life for a period of time, you know, in order to make where you're going a lot more clearer and allow you to grow and develop. As I said, you can't achieve nothing. You can't achieve what you want to achieve until you know yourself. So if you don't know yourself, then how are you meant to, especially in my job, if I didn't know myself, I couldn't understand other people and how to get them to achieve their goals and what they're going through in life that's going to affect their goals. So the more I learn about myself and go through stuff myself, the more I can help other people. So lose your self-belief, because that's just something that you need in order to get to where you want to get, because people will always have opinions. People are always going to have what ifs. Oh, that's not a good, because, oh, I wouldn't do that, or don't do that. That's their opinions, that's what they wouldn't do, and that's fair enough, that's entirely up to them. But it's a matter of risks in life are what get us to where we want to get. If we don't take risks, then you're going nowhere but where you are, basically. So in order to get to where you want to get, you've got to be courageous and you've got to want more than what you have. You've got to see that you've got a bigger purpose in life that you need to fulfill, rather than just accepting what is. Because sometimes we make choices in life based on what we wanted in that moment of time and what we felt we needed in that moment of time. And in the long term, it's actually what made you realise you don't particularly want that anymore, and you don't want to be going in that direction anymore, and you want to make changes, but you feel you've made your bed and that's it. But if you live like that, you'll never be happy. I think a lot of people claim happiness to be different, really. So what I want in life and what's going to make me happy is staying on route to where I feel I want to go and where I'm going and getting there. And I have to say, when things do get in the way, it sends me off track, basically, and I find this button, self-destruct, which I think we all have. We all have a button that's self-destruct. We just have to learn about ourselves. As I say, it's the most important thing. Make sure you know yourself. And if you're ambitious, never give up on it, because people are always going to have something to say. People are always going to want to have an opinion, because they're not achieving what they really want to achieve. So they're not making changes in their life that's going to make them happy. So they're always going to have something to say about yours. So that's just how it is, really. So what I will say is, no matter what circumstances you're in, no matter where you're at the moment, if there's somewhere you want to get, don't rule it out. Try not to say, don't tell yourself, I'm just not as fortunate as someone else, I'm not getting there. It's just that you're not going to get there as fast as them. So you just have to work harder, basically, and stay focused, make sacrifices. That's the biggest thing I will say, sacrifice. You've got to make sacrifices in order to get to where you want to get, which, if it means isolating yourself a little bit, unfortunately, that's what you have to do. And believe it or not, it's probably the best thing you could do for yourself, because it's a matter of becoming a stronger person and understanding yourself and your emotions and everything to get where you want to get.
Lonely, but as long as you're focusing on what you want and doing stuff that is going to get you there,
you're on the right track, basically. So if you assess yourself on what you want and you decide it's where you're going and the people you wanted to come with you don't, that's something you have to adapt to, something you have to grow with and understand and accept that sometimes things are out of your control. So what's the need to constantly worry about it? I can't say worry. Constantly worry, get yourself in a state of mind where everything's negative and having a clear thought is just impossible. It's just not a place to get. So it's best just to sometimes take a deep breath, get yourself out the house, normally helps. Get yourself out in the fresh air, always helps me. And just clear your head and just think, what is in my control? What can I change in order to feel better about my situation? And what can I do to make myself accept that? It's hard. So I just wanted to put this out because it's another reason I started up YouTube. I wanted to again give a little bit more in terms of motivation and helping people to achieve what they want and give people that little bit more of a realistic side, a reality of, because Instagram, although you can put out a picture and a quote and something motivational, people, but I just wanted to give a little bit more in terms of the reality of social media, because Instagram is, people post, but they might not even be feeling as positive as what they're posting, you know? So it's a matter of understanding that the fakery of social media is massive. it's big. So although my posts are pretty organic, I'm pretty sincere, and I generally always post in regards to how I'm feeling. So if I'm feeling a bit down, or if I'm feeling not quite as positive as I usually am, I then go and find things that are going to help me and get me back in that mindset, and something inspires me, so then I go and post in order to inspire others. So my posts are pretty organic to how I'm feeling, but when sometimes it's a matter of showing people real life and that it's social media is probably the most corrupt thing, but at the same time the best thing that was ever invented for businesses and stuff, but it's also very corrupt in terms of making people feel they're not as good as someone else, or they're not as, you know, their body's not as good, or it's silly, because the reality of everything is we're all humans. We all started from somewhere. We all want to go somewhere. So if there's a quote that I watched a film, and it said at the end, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. Does that make sense? So basically, yeah, you'll go faster and you'll get places quicker on your own, but you get further when you're carrying people with you and lifting people up. So that's just a little something I wanted to share with you all.
you have any questions or if any relation to what I've spoke about today, please do comment below and ask me any questions you might have in regards to what I've spoken about today. And please subscribe. If you're on your mobile device, it's the red button just below. If you're on a desktop, again, it should be anywhere. I don't know, you'll see the big red button saying subscribe. And stay tuned for some more videos. Yeah. Thank you.